Coming up on the special edition of How We Built It, we're joined by Singapore-based mobile technology company Grab, who built an everyday everything super app to match consumers to common services in Southeast Asia. Now we'll see how they're evaluating Azure Synapse to improve their data governance with things like dynamic data masking and RowLevel Security to empower business users in different countries and verticals to compliantly access and analyze their data. So I'm joined today by solution architect Adhi Utama, coming from Singapore today. Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
Thanks. It's great to be on the show.
And thanks so much for joining us today. And by the way, before we get into this, just a quick recap. If you're new to Azure Synapse, this is Microsoft's limitless analytics platform that really brings together data warehousing capabilities as well as big data processing into a single service. Now you can learn more at aka.ms/mechanics-synapse. Also, if you're new to Grab, they play an important role in terms of matchmaking and connecting micro entrepreneurs and customers deliver goods and services and have millions of people using their apps across Southeast Asia. Now they currently offer services across 8 countries in over 330 cities, everything from ride sharing, delivery, cashless payments, and more. So Adhi, with so many different services across so many different regions and countries, it's a pretty unique challenge to deliver this kind of service at scale and also in a secure way.
Right, it is. So we have about 300 or so analysts combing over 30 terabytes of data a day. And we are always looking to find the next opportunity to better serve our customer and to identify new services that we can bring into the market. We've been really focused on building a self-service analytics platform that allows the right permissions for our analysts to access data regardless of their skill level.
So how are you doing this right now? Can you describe your current setup?
Sure. Let me show you with the visual to explain. Our original solution was open source based. We decoupled our compute and storage engine. Our data lake is storage, and we use Presto for our compute and data warehousing. Our analysts could query from a number of interfaces, such as our internal ETL tools for SQL-based querying to get filtered views of data, or they can use data visualization tools and notebooks. Now, as we've grown, we needed a way that supports a better data governance, as the current solution doesn't natively support rich access control features. So there's no row-level security, there's no column-level security in the current solution. We've had to constantly duplicate the data for each country and filter the views manually. There are a number of pain points here. For example, because the data is live queried and not cached, it needs to be recomputed each time we access it. This increases our compute costs and reduces performance. Now, to ensure the right access control is in place, our data engineers need to create multiple views per table available based on the location. This results in a high maintenance and storage overhead. And of course, at the end of the day, this isn't very scalable.
Yeah, so it's kind of the opposite. When we think about role-based access controls, you're actually having to create bespoke data sets then for every individual access requirement. So if you start to kind of extrapolate this across 8 different countries, 8 views, the same table, and you factor that then by city, it sounds like you'd have to create maybe hundreds of views or more of the same data.
Exactly. We have petabytes of data that are constantly changing every day, and we have around 1,000 active dashboards that our analysts are using. Now, our analysts are having to recreate the access control literally one dashboard at a time.
So how have you approached then your solution and your evaluation with Azure Synapse to respond to this and make things better?
Right. So we've now started to develop a more mature model for data governance and analytics in a single service. The raw data comes into our data lake on Azure, and we are able to transform them using Synapse in conjunction with Azure Databricks. We store our processed data in SQL pools for data warehousing capabilities. From here on, we are able to query the data and visualize it through notebooks at scale. And the most exciting part for us is the governance capabilities that can be achieved through row level and column level security. This allows us to lock down the data at the cell level. And we also have dynamic data masking, which allows us to detect sensitive data while it is being shared with analysts. And we're also able to have a unified authentication system with Azure Active Directory with multi-factor authentication across these services.
And that's a huge improvement from a security perspective. And if you're new to row-level security, you can make sure that users only have access and visibility to those data roles that are pertinent to their location or their vertical or their role. Now, this all happens against the same shared data set, so there's no duplication that's required. But can we take a look at what you've implemented here using Azure Synapse?
Yeah, absolutely. So here, I have created what we call as a filter predicate. This pre-filters the data before an analyst can query it. It contains the logic for row-level security. In this example, we are using record type ID column that represents country, city, and vertical. Next, we create a security policy that calls the predicate and applies it into our tables in Synapse. Yeah, so let me start by showing you the kind of filtering logic that we have against our data. So let's run this. And what you'll see is that even though I'm an admin, I don't have a row level access to this data. Therefore, the query will return an empty set. Let's try this out by running the same query with two different AD authorized users. The query on the left is for an analyst that is the head of vertical. For example, our rights sharing business across three countries. It's trying to query a metrics in units of hour against our CRM system. On the right, you see the exact same query for that one of our country heads is running. So let's see what happens when I run these queries for each analyst. First, when I run the query on the left, you see that the results are scoped to three countries, which is based on what this analyst is allowed to see. And then on the right, when you run the same query, you can see that only one result specific to this country are returned for this analyst. This means it simplifies our audit process. It simplifies our data governance process. It improves our speed of execution and time to insights. And it's also more efficient because we are using less compute and storage.
Now you don't need to create multiple views against the same data, but you also mentioned that you're using dynamic data masking. Can you show us how that would work?
Yeah, sure. So with dynamic data masking, we can ensure that sensitive information is secured without limiting the analysis that we can do. If you're familiar with GDPR, we also have similar regulation here called PDPA, Personal Data Protection Act. And here, let me show you the demo. Here we have a table with some information that we want to mask, such as phone number and email address. I can mask the data with zero engineering effort. I can choose from a number of pre-built functions to mask, in this case, email and phone numbers. So now, as an analyst, let me run a query that includes email and phone numbers. And you see that everything is masked. So the information is redacted. What it means is I can still do analysis, but I won't be able to see the sensitive information. This gives data governance team the peace of mind, while at the same time empowering our analysts to do their work efficiently.
It's great to see these two different vectors of security. You're able to provide the right access to information at scale without any of the workarounds that you were doing before. But what's up next for Grab?
So Azure Synapse get us closer to our data governance goal of having a data warehouse as the central source of truth for powering reporting analysis for our data scientists, analysts, and data communities at Grab. It also helps to establish a single source of truth for clean, curated, and reliable analytical metrics and data. And now, access control can also be implemented and maintained in a scalable, centralized way with audit controls. So yeah, we are pretty excited for the future.
That's great. And thank you so much for joining us today, Adhi. And by the way, if you liked hearing from Grab about their Azure Synapse evaluation, please check out the rest of our How We Built It series at aka.ms/Azure Synapse series to learn from early adopters also kicking the tires with Azure Synapse. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye for now.